What happened?
I'm trying to explain to him. I'm like, I think he thinks that I'm gay. I'm like, guys at Lyft aren't gay. You know I'm not gay. I work out all the time. I'm super strong.
Straight as an arrow. A broken arrow.
I don't know what's making him not believe me, but I think he thinks I'm gay.
So this is a trigger point, so it triggers it as a pain.
This is going to be the size of the patch that we're putting awesome. For the gangsta stuff. It's already ordered. These are the shorts that you already saw that we're working on, like the lounger pair,
right?
Which is not like the high-end stuff. So then from there, the
eggplant.
Same, yeah, from there the same size patch will be like kind of on the leg.
I'm gonna turn into a cage fighter. Are you ready for this? Drop your ear in like this.
So this is built by the strongest ship in the West.
MMA.
What's up? Is there any way in here?
Where you at, Cody Garbrandt? So, just always trying to just be a little different and trying to make people understand how much time and effort we put into our products. And so, we put the ST on there so that you know that it's authentic. When you see the guys, the hip-hop guys, the rappers and stuff with their hat on, and they leave the sticker on there, they leave it on there for authenticity reasons. I don't know if you guys ever seen the skit, I think it was Key and Peele. But they go pretty far. Insert quick clip of it here. They go pretty far with keeping it real, let's say. But yeah, I wanted to put that on there. That way people know it's from Super Training, and every single thing that we've ever worked on here at Super Training Gym has my stamp on it, has my approval on it. And so we stick that sticker on there. And this is our new Gains Season hat that I'm really excited about because that's what's coming. We got Thanksgiving, right? We're gonna be bulking up. We got Thanksgiving and Christmas, and because of that, I'm fasting today and going to be messing around with some fasting coming up because I know that the fatness is coming and I know that the gains are coming quick. One of one, a failed hat. We just weren't happy with the design, so sometimes that's what happens. Win some, lose some. Ordered a shit ton of coffee. Blast our faces off. Yeah. We're gonna get fired up over here. No more pussyfooting around. Whatever that means. Anyway. Oh, that one went off already.
This one. Oh.
It's complicated.
Like MacGyver right now.
The place blows up. What's going on? Boom, we're in there. Just let these go off forever, see if it starts to bother anybody.
No, you're shooting in here, so you can keep your coffee with you.
So I've been exploring books from all over the world. Been to Brazil, Guatemala, a bunch of other places I can't pronounce. And I've searched the world for the finest coffees, the finest chocolates, the finest this, the finest that. And this was the last book I got. And I was on page 327. And it said that this would be the best for our strong coffee. And so this is what we're working on today. We're gonna put some beans inside here, and hopefully it's gonna amount to a hill of beans. Coffee beans, that is. Strong coffee. That's what we're working on. That's what we're here for today. You gotta sip it loudly. That's the way it works.
And we'll punch the numbers in, and it'll tell us exactly how strong strong coffee really is.
Ain't gonna lie, this is pretty exciting. It's pretty cool. Oh, lovely. Oh, really good. Has this machine ever exploded before?
Not this one. So we have an extraction percentage of just over 22%. So you remember that middle bar I was showing you?
Yeah.
Well, that's that middle bar right there. But our coffee is so strong, it's literally off the normal spectrum.
Nice.
So at 20.22% with a TDS of 1.73, we're brewing some strong coffee.
Das Boot.
Having a really tough time with Hustlemania today because Andrew does so much for the company that he had to pass the camera off to one of our rookies, and our rookie right now is just not doing a very good job of getting this done and getting this filmed. Doesn't understand how to use a Fuji camera, just having a really, really rough go of it. Anyway, as always, we're going to fight through this. We're going to continue onward and upward, putting one foot in front of the other. We're working on sponsored ads here at Slingshot, and it's interesting how difficult like one little task is. We're looking for photos of somebody in Slingshot. We're looking for photos of somebody in our knee sleeves. And as we sift through, we're finding like, oh, that picture is too complicated because somebody's wearing an ST shirt, and they're wearing a competitor's belt, and they're wearing this, and they're wearing that. And so as we start to sift through, you would figure we'd have millions of photos, and we do. We have a lot of photos, but we're looking for very precise photos that are gonna be squared off because they're gonna be probably for Instagram. And so this is a new challenge for us. Everything that seems like it's simple, whenever you see these sponsored ads from other companies, or you see anything that goes up on YouTube or anywhere, it's always met with some resistance. And so that's what we're working on today. We're trying to find a good clean photo that is that has the right angle, that has the right person. We're looking for people to not be so fat, and you know, sometimes we're able to get these great pictures, but it's just not exactly what we're looking for. So we're going to keep sifting through them. All right, so sifting through pictures, and I'm trying to think of these creative ideas, and I'm like, you know, maybe we could use John Cena in an ad, and we can just have a really good photo of our knee sleeves. The knee sleeves are just floating, and we can say, you know, here's John Cena squatting 700 pounds in our knee sleeves. You can't see me, get it, da-da-da-da-da. Thinking of fun, creative ideas, and then I came up with probably one of my best ideas of all time, which is to use this picture right here. Wah-bam. Look at that face. A face only Rosemary Bell can love. This is the original, your off the team photo. I was in a hotel room with Mr. Jesse Burdick, and he and I traveled the United States together, doing seminars all over the place when we were doing CrossFit powerlifting seminars. And Jesse had the same routine. Every time we got into a hotel room, he'd break it in by just ripping the loudest fart he possibly could. And then he would dive on the bed. He would take off all his stuff, and he would just dive on the bed, and he'd lay there in his socks and underwear, and he'd be like spread eagle. And he'd just put his hand down his pants, and he'd like be scratching his balls so loud, like I could hear it from, you know, being on the other side of the room. And I was like, this is fucking, he's so gross. He does this every time. And I'm like, that's it. I'm like, I'm getting a picture of this fat motherfucker. And I was like, about ready to snap a photo. And then as soon as I picked up my chin a little bit, as soon as I looked down, it was my own face. So I made a little like funny smirk kind of on purpose, just because it kind of looked ridiculous to me. And I snapped the photo and I sent it to him while he's on the bed next to me. And he's already checking his phone. He's thumbing through some stuff, and he looks at it. He's like, "Oh my god!" And he just starts dying laughing. And he falls off his bed. That's the "you're off the team" photo.
What happened?
I'm trying to explain to him. I'm like, I think he thinks that I'm gay. I'm like, guys at Lyft aren't gay. You know I'm not gay. I work out all the time. I'm super strong.
Straight as an arrow. I'm broken. Broken arrow.
I don't know what's making him not believe me, but I think he thinks I'm gay. I don't know, from what I hear, you need carbohydrates to have veins. I haven't eaten anything today. Like I got a couple veins. Back. What happens?
Cause he's like, I smell toast. I'm like, oh my gosh, are you having a stroke?
About work stuff, and you're just too busy doing arms. I have some pertinent pictures to show you. So this is Mark. This is Mark Bell looking away. This is Mark Bell looking at the camera. So tonight's post, I created some good content in terms of our new channel, Strong Apparel.
I think people need to see both posts, don't they?
So you can do a little swipe action. You like that one as your home, as the main, the first one? Or that one as the first one?
What do you think? What do you like better?
I like that one a lot, but
less,
I like how you're
ears.
Looking at them.
I got
well,
huge ears.
Swipe's gonna be squared up, so it'll be a little tighter.
Alright.
You do have rather large ears.
You know why?
Huh.
Because I used to make fun of my grandfather's ears. So it came back to me.
I don't know actually. They look on this picture, it looks a lot bigger than it is.
Such a good picture though.
Mm-hmm. Whoever took it is not good.
That's a nice shirt. It's like,
hustle hard. Dude.
Look at that vein.
Bugged out.
I need Botox.
Yeah.
Such a good
Botox, picture. Comment below.
Yeah, so it's going to be these tonight.
All right, well, we're done with our training session. That one looks good.
Cool.
We're done with our training session for today. Got through a lot of work. Today was day uno of having our media team on a schedule. So we got to whip those guys into shape. But that's going to really help us with productivity. Andy and I, all day long, we're working on tying up some loose ends with a bunch of things. Still working on getting more flooring here for the gym. Got a little bit of a snafu with some of that. We've been working on hard on that. And then we have like the most disgusting bathroom you've ever seen. So we're working on cleaning that up. A lot of these people that we want to pay, they're not around. All we want to do is give them some dough. But apparently that's a hard thing to do. This day and age, if you just do your job, you know what you're called? You're called exceptional. So don't work so hard. Don't over fucking think it all the time. Just do your damn job. Strength is never a weakness. Weakness is never strength. I'm out of here. Whoosh. Not bad, that's my boy Nick Platt. I almost forgot though. We did something spatial via the Instagrams, and by we, I mean myself, Andy Frisella, Mike O'Tren. You guys may have heard the name before. Heath Evans, Todd Abrams, all from, all celebrities in the fitness community, all icons in the fitness world. And we all posted up a challenge for people to join us on a fat kid fast. Us fat kids really got to stick together. And so we did a 24-hour fast, and I wanted to congratulate all you guys that followed along on the IG. Coming up soon, I'm going to do a 48-hour fast and also a 60-hour fast. I'm not looking forward to it, so it's hard for me to even say it out loud. But today for me wasn't bad. It's 5:30. It's almost 5:40 right now. And my last meal last night, I had some pork belly wings from a place called DeVere's. I know, pork belly wings. Those things are amazing. Anyway, I feel really good. My wife wants to eat with me right now, but I actually just like, I would like to just keep the fast rolling. But I don't think she'll allow for that. I think she's gonna make me eat some food. Anyway, if you never tried a fast before, I think you should give it a try, you know? You don't have to jump in. You don't have to jump in the deep end right away. Go in the kiddie pool and stick your toes in there and try. I want you guys to try about a 10-hour fast. 10 hours isn't too bad. You finish your last meal at like 9 o'clock at night and see if you can make it for about 10 hours, maybe even 12 hours, somewhere in that neighborhood. Remember, the earlier that you stop eating, the sooner that you get to eat the next morning. So for some of you, that might matter because you might really enjoy breakfast before heading out to work. But give it a try, give it a shot. Make sure you're hydrated, make sure you're drinking more water than normal. Make sure you're getting in some salt. You can add salt to whatever food you eat later in the day, or just simply add a little salt to your water, as I am always doing anyway. Anyway, fasting has been really beneficial for me. It's been hugely beneficial in my quest recently to lose 60 pounds. And it can be highly beneficial for those of you that are on a ketogenic diet because it's gonna help you to produce more ketones. Being fasted has also given me a ton of energy. Even though it's you know, 20 some odd hours that I've been fasted right now, I feel like I have a ton of energy. I woke up at fucking 4 o'clock this morning and got my first post out to you guys on Instagram by 5 a.m. And I feel like I can go all goddamn day. So give it a try. Like I said, start out slow. 10 to 12 hours would be a good start. Strength is never a weakness. See you guys later for real this time. Later.